إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. greet you all with the greeting of Islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series, Corona. And today, inshallah, we have segment number 104. No, excuse me. We have segment number 20. Again, this is our series concerning Corona. And this is segment number 20. And we're going to be dealing with wind, storm, hurricane, to some Muslims they see that they need to protect themselves from corona. This is fine. Allah give you means and ways to shelter yourself and to protect yourself. The clothes, the houses, the medicine, all the things for your own, to take care of yourself, to stay healthy, to stay clean, so you can be able to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a better way. But we have to understand it's not only corona that we need to be shielded against it. We have other things. And today we're talking about wind. What is wind? Wind exactly the same breathe, same air that you... But it comes with a stronger speed. So it's going to change it from what you may call it a air or a cool breeze to something to be asifa, to be a storm, to be hurricane. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it the speed, give it the ability that it can be harmful, harm. And as we understand, same way that the virus, doesn't matter coronavirus or the swine flu or whatever, it is nothing but a one of Allah's soldiers. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. No one knows the soldiers of Allah other than Allah. All these things that you see or you don't see, that you know about or you don't know about it, is part of Allah's army, and Allah can make it move against His people at any time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't even need for these things to move, because a matter of saying be, it will be. As Allah is saying, إِن يَشَأْ يُذْهِبُكُمْ وَيَأْتِ بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ. Saying, O people, you are poor and in total need to Allah. And Allah is the only one self-sufficient, free of any needs of anyone. If He, Almighty, will, He will remove you all, not some of you, all. And He will bring about a different creation and different people. So, coronavirus is one small soldier of Allah. Now, the same breath, and He says, cool breath, it's so nice outside, okay? This can be in a second like this. Turn to something, you call it riyah, awasif, storm, hurricane. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say dua for protection against the wind. And he used to say, Allahumma inni as'aluka khayraha wa a'udhu bika min sharriha. There is a longer hadith than this, related in the same subject, but I choose this. It will be easier for you to remember and to memorize. Allahumma inni as'aluka khayraha wa a'udhu bika min sharriha. O Allah, I ask you out of the good of this storm or this wind, and I seek refuge in thee from the evil of such thing, which is wind. The other one he used to say, Allahumma inni as'aluka khayraha wa khayra ma fiha wa khayra ma ursilat bih wa a'udhu bika min sharriha wa sharri ma fiha wa sharri ma ursilat bih. The first one in the collection of Imam Abu Dawood and Ibn Majah, and the second one is in the collection of Bukhari and Imam Muslim, rahmatullahi alayhima. What is the difference between the first and the second? Both of them for protection against wind and hurricane. But the second one is with more details. The first one is about one line and a half. The second supplication is four lines. If you can memorize the second one, it's good. If not, at least learn what to say when the wind start pick up. All right? Now you see it? It's getting harder. Speed. Now you need to say and make your protection. Same way you put your mask in your nose to breathe through it, so the germs doesn't, corona doesn't come to you. So the same thing, this wind, the wind is carrying something you don't know even what it's carrying. And subhanallah, وَجَعَلْنَا الرِّيَاحَ لَوَاقِحَ. Allah says that we made the wind for mean of fertilizing and multiplying the crops. Okay, that Allah makes the wind to carry. So sometimes the wind can be for something good and can be for something bad. Okay, as example, it takes the seeds from the male organ or the male plant, and it fly to the female plant. So it can fertilize and give more and more. So this is khair, this is good. But in same time also the wind can be storm, and it can be heavy rain, it can be a flood as a result of the rain, so, and this can be disaster, okay? So subhanallah, how Allah can make the same thing, can be a soldier to protect you, or a soldier to destroy a person, or a people. And why we go too far? Remember, Ad and Thamud. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the wind for the people of Ad and Thamud, these two tribes, for 7 days and eight nights. Can you imagine this hurricane? This strong, it used to take the person, you understand, shoot him in the air and fall in his head, he's dead. Moving houses, picking trees out of its roots. So you never know what you think can be one of Allah's soldiers. So we always have to make dua to ask Allah, because only Allah is the one who can protect us from this. Don't count in 9-1, because 9-1-1, okay, after a day or after a week, now we don't have any more beds. We don't have any more muscles. We don't have any more breathing machine, okay? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Akbar, okay? So you're saying, Allahumma inni as'aluka khayraha. Oh Allah, I ask you the good and the blessings of this wind, and the good that in it, and the good that you had sent it for. So it carries a mission. So you want the good of it. Make it cools. Outside, there is no air condition. And now a nice breeze comes. You say, oh, subhanallah, look how this nice breeze. All right, this is one thing. And also it be carrying good things in it, bringing some rain so people can water their plants. And it can be other things that we don't know, or that Allah send it for is specific place and specific people to water their land. And also you say, O Allah, أعوذ بك من شرها. O Allah, I seek refuge in thee from the evil of this wind or this storm, and from the evil that it contains in it, and the evil of what mission that it is about. Three things. Okay? The evil of it, the evil that it carrying it, it can be carrying virus, okay? And also it can be a mission to destroy a country or a people, like people of Ad and Thamud. Let's see the translation here for this. It's saying invocation for when wind blows. And the two collection is there. The first one, O Allah, I ask you for the good of it, and seek refuge in you against its evil. As for the second dua, is more details, O Allah, I ask you for the good of it, for the good of what contains, and for the good of what is sent with it. O Allah, I seek refuge in you from the evil of it. It referring to what? To the wind, the storm. From the evil of what it contains, and from the evil that is sent with it. Subhanallah. See how the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was always feeling what is around him, his surrounding, interacting with the things that is happening in our nature and our dunya. If it's rain, if it's wind, if it's earthquake, he has something always to remember Allah and beg Allah for such occasion, regardless if it's something good or something bad. There is a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which he's saying, what the meaning is, Ar-rihu min rawhillah. Wind and storm is part of Allah's mercy. تأتي بالرحمة وتأتي بالعذاب. It comes with its good and it comes with its punishment. فإذا رأيتموها فلا تسبوها. So if you experience it, do not curse it. And instead of cursing it, you say, واسألوا الله من خيرها واستعيذوا بالله من شرها. Ask Allah from the good of this wind or storm and seek protection against it in whatever contains. This is the proper behavior. Allah can send the wind as a means of mercy for some people, and it can be a means for punishment for some people. We ask Allah to show His mercy to us in whatever He gives us, or for whatever that He withholds from us. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you is good, and you say Alhamdulillah. And whatever that Allah sends that you see it is an evil, is still a good, that Allah remove some of your sins, or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala waken you up from what you're doing that you are not supposed to be doing. This for today, and inshallah, hopefully that you will remember this dua, so you can utilize it inshallah. I will repeat it 2-3 times for those who inshallah planning to memorize it or to practice it. Allahumma inni as'aluka خيرها وأعوذ بك من شرها. Again, اللهم إني أسألك خيرها وأعوذ بك من شرها. Again and the last time, Allahumma, O Allah, inni, indeed I, as'aluka, I ask you and I beg you, khayraha, the good of this storm, wa, and a'udhu, I seek refuge, bika, with you, min, from, Sharriha, it's evil. Thank you for being here. Looking forward to see you again tomorrow, inshallah. By the way, before I forgot, the CIC mini seminar is not going to be taking place in gathering, so we're going to have it with a social destination on Zoom. But inshallah, I will try to broadcast it. First lecture will be tomorrow after Maghrib, inshallah, about 8:30 p.m. And the first lecture concerning raising children in Islam. All right? The second lecture will be approximately about 12 o'clock noontime on Saturday, And the third and the last lecture will be after Dhuhr, inshallah. Stay tuned and looking forward to see you tomorrow, inshallah, for Corona segment. I'm your host, Muhammad Saleh Adli from Columbia, South Carolina. Have a good time with the remembrance of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us well, healthy, and help us to remember Him at all times. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.